mind, it's not easy coming up and performing in front of people all the time. So a little bit of courtesy wouldn't go amiss this evening. If we could remain half silent during the acts, that would be absolutely fantastic this evening. And of course, a little round of applause once we've finished. Now this evening, ladies and gents, we have three very prestigious judges joining us. Hopefully, they're going to wait until they're called. Thank you. The entrants will be coming through the same door as your judges will be looking at right now. So, ladies and gents, we're going to start you off with your first judge this evening. And we're going to introduce to you Claire. Claire, would you like to come and join us through this side? There and does 2 minutes of whatever she's going to do. Claire is originally from Bromley. Claire has moved to Southery in 2001 when she married David. She is a staunch supporter of Keeping Abreast, a breast cancer charity. And I've lost entirely where I was on the thing. That's not a very good start, is it? So I'm going to have to lift it up and do this. Always be seen with a smile on her face. And Claire might find judging just a little bit difficult this evening because she's got this infallible ability to always be nice to people. So we're going to go to her a lot and see what she thinks about the acts. I think that's where we're going to go. So Claire, would you like to go and take your seat in the centre of the judging table this evening? Music because it seems to fit for the next one. So Nicole, would you like to come through? Yeah, you see I changed it at the last moment. So Nicole started street dancing at 7 locally, which led her to join the elite team and competed in many competitions across the country. Continuing her success, she has travelled to many places like Denmark, Germany, Italy and Scotland to help represent England. Nicole and her team won the world champion title for street dance and hip-hop in Germany in 2014. In 2015, she entered Britain's Got Talent with Entity, where they received the golden buzzer from Alicia Pixel. Since making it through to the finals, she has also been in Street Dance, the movie, which premiered in London earlier on this year. And while Nicole is studying hard for her GCSEs at the moment, she's also training to go to Vegas to represent England in Street Dance. So ladies and gents, put your hands together for Nicole this evening. We have our last judge, who's really nervous. So Jane, would you like to come through? She's going to be the heroic judge this evening. Jane Target is a chef originally from Coveney and enjoys playing with Play-Doh or making cakes. As you can see this evening, she is partial to a glass of Pinot. It's the one over there with the bottle. I hope you're going to be nice to people. Are you really nervous yet? Shall I make you stand there a little bit longer? She wanted to live the high life, so she said yes immediately to being a judge. And I'm going to let her sit down now, because she's not doing anything. She's just sort of wobbling. Our esteemed panel of judges will be going through everybody with a fine-tooth comb this evening, picking out everything that is good and bad, hopefully more good than the bad. So we are looking, I hope we are going to have our first person ready to go. Now we're going to start off the proceedings this year with the way they finished before. So luckily enough, we have the winner of the last Southery's Got Talent with us. So, Lily Robson, would you like to come and entertain the guests and show them how well you did last time? So, ladies and gents, please put your hands together for Lily as she starts to make her way up towards the stage. And she's going to start it off this evening. Exactly what they think of each and every one of our contestants. Do you think they can lie convincingly? I'm not sure. Right, so we're going to be looking for our first contestant up this evening. So ladies and gents, please put your hands together. And I'm hoping that our first contestant is going to be ready. So, I am going to be looking for Izzy Perry. Izzy, can you come and join us up on the stage, please? Now, while she's making her way through, I have to say that she's a rather unique barmaid from the Old White Ballad, who you can see behind the bar here tonight if you don't happen to see her up on the stage. She is appearing in doing the pantomime this year and is going to be singing for you tonight. And hopefully, I'm going to get this right this time. Told me don't dare come to me first. So, Jane, What have you got to say? Anything?
Yes, I have. You totally made that song your own, Izzy.
She's gone.
How rude! Is she back in behind the bar already?
Yes.
Did you hear that? No. Okay, so you're going to have to do it again.
Which one was it?
Well, you only heard one.
You totally made that your own, Izzy.
What?
Can I have another glass of wine?
Yes.
Is that bribery? I don't think that works. Right, so well done indeed to our first contestant, Izzy. Well done indeed to you. Right, well, so we're going to get up with our second one this evening. So, ladies and gents, I'm going to ask you once again, please make sure your mobile phones are turned off. It was lovely in the corner to see lots and lots of you with your phones up and your lights waving, but they were quite obviously phones that were still turned on. So our next singer is going to be doing an a cappella version. So Jess Tofts, would you like to come head your way through from the other side of the curtain and make your way up towards the stage? Jess, are you there? Bonus, jeez. So while she's on her way through, I have to tell you that Jess is a 9-year-old pupil at Southery Academy. She likes reading, math, singing, and going to youth club. Her favourite group is Little Mix. And as I said a little while ago, she's going to sing a cappella for you this evening. To a song that I absolutely love. So good luck indeed to you, and take it away.
Wrapped up, so consumed by all this if you ask me, don't know where to start. Anger, love, confusion, woes to go nowhere. I know there's somewhere better, cause your words take me there. Came to you with a broken faith, gave me more than a hand to hold. Caught before would you take the wheel if I lose control? If I'm lying here, or would you take me home? Could you take care of a broken soul? Would you hold me now, or would you take me home? Or would you take me lying here, or would you take me home?
singing that. I tell you what, it's not very easy singing at the Barons. You've done it very, very well indeed. I love that song. It's one of my favourite songs from 2 years ago. Is it 2 years ago? Wow, I'm getting really old now. So we're going to come across to our judges' table, the lovely panel that sits in front of everybody, judging them all on how good their vocals are, on how good they look, on how good their hair's done. What would I get? I would get 10 out of 10. I love you. I haven't even sung, all I've done is just sort of stand in front of you and I'm already 10 out. What would I get this side? 10. 10? Bones? Go on, for the whole...
10? 10?
Be alright. Wow. I love you. Right, so where are we going to go? Let's go along the table. So Claire, what would you like to say about my last act?
Jess. Stunning. To do it, is it called a cappella without music? It's amazing. See the nerves at the beginning, but I'd be nervous doing that, but I'm nervous doing this. So, but absolutely stunning. We could see your confidence build throughout, and it was wonderful. Well done.
Well done, indeed, and thank you very much indeed for all the positive things that I have to say. Well done. So that means that we're going to head on to our next contestant this evening. Well, hopefully we're going to have behind the curtain in the corner, Sammy. So Samantha Perry, would you like to start heading your way this way? Now Samantha is your youngest competitor this evening. She's only 6. Back on stage ever since appearing in Southery's pantomime Jack and the Beanstalk earlier on this year. And she's going to be singing a song that some of you may have already guessed by her dress. Some of you may have already guessed. She should have one. And that's because you're having mine, isn't it? Because you're too small.
Oh,
So thank you very much indeed, and congratulations to you. Well done indeed for singing that song at only 6 years old. Now, ladies and gents, I have been asked, because personally I wondered why there was a horse running through the middle. It's not a horse, it was Sven. So if you've... Can you not wait until I've introduced you? So if you've seen the film, there is a reindeer in it that I believe is called Sven. Somehow I've managed to escape seeing the film. Have you seen the film, Nicole? You have seen the film. And what do you think of that number that you were just given?
I thought that was brilliant. You have such a beautiful voice and you made it so fun. It was really enjoyable to watch. Well done.
And what about Sven's guest appearance?
That was really fun and it made it really enjoyable. Well done.
Did you know it was Sven? Liar. Did anyone in here know it was Sven?
Yeah.
Apart from Kath, who came and told me. Well done indeed. Congratulations to our little act that was just on. Right, so it's time for our next act up this evening. So hopefully behind there we should have another young lady. So I am looking this time for Emma Corbett. Emma, are you behind there? Emma is 11 years old and lives in Bearsingham. She has been dancing with her old team stage school for nearly 3 years. And in that time, she has performed at various fates, carnivals and festivals, as well as two professional pantos at the Princess Theatre in Hunstanton. And she's currently in rehearsals for third. Good luck to you as well. Congratulations, well done indeed. And I'm going to go for this end as well, because I can go wherever I want to. I'm a man, I've got a microphone, I'm wearing trousers. The floor's mine this evening. So Jane, what did you think?
I thoroughly enjoyed that.
You did. Well done. Well done indeed. Thank you very much indeed. Well done indeed to my young lady over there. Congratulations to you. So ladies and gents, that's it. We're halfway through this evening. Now, I have been told that what's going to happen is that we're going to get through all 10 acts this evening. Then the judges will narrow it down. They're going to do their whole ruthless thing. If you look at their faces, they're very evil, some of them. Especially that one in the middle. They're going to narrow it down to three. The final three acts will then perform again, and I am led to believe that you all have tickets. Is this correct? Table on my left, is this correct? There's only one of you sitting on a table, is that right? Table on my left, is that right?
Yes!
Table on my right, is that right? Honestly, I said, why do you bother sometimes? Right, so we are going to be looking for our next finalist this evening. So I am going to be looking for Chloe Filippo. Would you like to come and head your way through this side for me? Ladies and gents, don't be afraid. You can put your hands together as Chloe makes her way to the stage. She's 14. Music and acting have been her passions for a long time. She's been involved in lots of local productions. And there's no way I can read all this in that time. But basically, where we're going with this is she hopes you enjoy her rendition.
Right, so we're going to hopefully head on to our next
singer this evening. I say singer, I actually sort of mean, how can I describe these next group of people? I've got a thing behind here that's been written out about everybody that I'm meant to be reading. But this afternoon, I thought, no, there's no way I'm possibly going to read that out. This next group that are going to come up are possibly the best act I saw during the day. Not because they're very entertaining. I'm going to put it that way, they're very entertaining. So, can we please have up to the stage the girls that are going to be called Little Miss Knows It All. Ladies, we're going to get you up onto the stage, and I'm going to have to remember how I do this now, because yours is different. Because they know it all. Right, so we're going to head on to our next act up this evening. So my next act up this evening, you're going to notice that I'm going to be heading backwards and forwards just a little bit this evening because I'm going to be doing this. And I'm going to come around the side and I'm going to go and get another thing. So we are going to be looking for my next act, and hopefully they are going to be up behind that little banner at the back there. So I am going to be looking for Izzy Smith. Is she there? Bonus. Now I normally do one of the talky bit while they're heading away, but I'm still setting the stage up. So ladies and gents, just while she's strapping herself in and plugging in, I'm going to tell you just a little bit about my young lady up here this evening. But before I get that far, I have to come round so I can read it. Right. Isabella Rose Smith is 17 years old, and she's been playing a variety of music since she was 5. Really? I couldn't even read music when I was 5. She's been playing old... Since she was 5 years old. She currently studies music at a college in Cambridge, sings a variety of genres, however, folk, pop and classical are her main areas, as well as writing your own songs. So well done indeed for writing your own songs, well done indeed for being able to read music when you were 5. There's no possible way I could do that. And good luck. And I'm gonna try and fix that. You can stop the tape any time. Is it not tape anymore? Do they not have tapes no more then? Harsh. It's very harsh. At least I didn't say reel to reel. Okay, can you just play me a note?
Oh,
Just drop it. Not the guitar. That was me trying to be clever. Thanks. Look, I've got a boy. I dropped it in paper. I think I've noticed. Right, so next up this evening, we are going to be going to our judges to find out exactly what they thought about this. Now, I'm standing over here, I'm looking at the judges, and I'm thinking, which one should I go to next? Why are you smiling? Because you know I'm coming to you. Why would I possibly be going to you? You are the next one. Yeah, well done, Evie. So what did you think of that one?
I think she's a star in the making. Absolutely amazing.
Thank you very much indeed. I thought it was very good myself. And I'm going to come to the end here again. And Nicole?
I thought that was really amazing. Wow, you just literally gave me goosebumps so much. You've got real talent. Well done.
So congratulations and well done indeed. Ladies and gents, one more time, please put your hands together this evening for Izzy as she heads her way back through the other side, hiding the guitar out of the way. So with a bit of luck, we're on to number 9, should my maths be correct, and we're going to be going back to someone that you've already seen perform this evening. So I'm hoping that Lily is behind the curtain over there. So Lily, if you're there, make your way back up to the stage. Enjoys singing and trampolining as well. And she's wearing glasses. I like the glasses. Thank you very much indeed. You may head your way off of the stage as I go and talk to the judges this evening one more time to find out how she got on performing Hopeful this evening. So I'm going to go to Claire in the middle. Claire, what would you have to say about that?
Lily, you definitely made it your own song. Well done, you nailed it.
Yeah, you see, I like that. It sort of works, and well done indeed, Lily, for doing it. But, ladies and gents out here, have you noticed that the judges keep using the term, and you made it your own? Claire, what did you think of that?
She made it her own.
Okay, let's go for a different make it your own. I don't want to make it your own. Make it your own is, it's repetitive. It's the same thing. You're seeing different acts. They're pouring their hearts out to you this evening. And we've got you make it your own. The good parts are good. Go on.
It was really good.
Congratulations, thank you very much indeed to the judges. Right now, ladies and gents, we are going to have a very different type of act to finish off your 10 acts this evening. So we must ask you please, if you have children in the room, can you please take hold of them and keep them with you for your next act? We are going to be heading around the room and just gently flicking off lights. So I believe Kevin's going to head to the corner. I'm going to head here. And then I'm going to head over to the other corner. So ladies and gents, if you are afraid of the dark, find yourself a friend and hold their hand. That's what I suggest. No lights. You make me have no lights and then you want me to turn off my only light. And then I've still got to read something. You're not making this very easy for me, are you? Right, so ladies and gents, because I can't actually read what's written in front of me anymore, I believe we have Cindy Rooney coming up to entertain you all this evening. So Cindy, would you like to come and take centre stage or not quite? That's possibly the first time I've ever seen that done. So what I can now see I'm going to just help fill you in a little bit on Sydney. Sydney is currently on a pit stop travelling to pay a surprise visit to her mum for her 50th birthday. She will soon again be off to pursue her career as a driving instructor in Indonesia.
Diving!
Okay, it's the writing. Taking part apparently was a very last minute decision, or this morning's decision, and she would like to thank Martin and Lewis for making her boy today. So congratulations to the boys. Well done indeed to all young lady over that side. Really? You just made it. That was it. So we're going to come to our judges, and how do you think the boy was made? Was it made well? Did Martin do a good job? Martin's lovely. Martin, you're lovely.
I'm
okay,
Martin.
Okay, so how do you think he went?
Did you make it all right?
I wasn't going to say that. It's amazing, the Rubies always come up with something surprising. And that was very surprising. Well done. Was that something that you learned while you were away?
Maybe.
Really good.
Thank you very much indeed. So once again, ladies and gents, please bring your hands together this evening for Sydney. Well done indeed. And she starts to make her way back through another five once again. So ladies and gents, it's now come to that time in the evening where our judges need to make up their minds. It's the final chance for them to decide exactly who it is that they're going to put through as their final three. Are you nervous, judges? Are you nervous? Jamie, are you nervous? Why are you nervous? You've seen everyone. Each one of the contestants has made everything that they've got their own. You've got to pick 3 out of 10. I tell you what, I'm actually very glad that I'm not a judge, because I don't think that I can pick 3 out of 10. Ladies and gents, have you got your favourites out here? It's still only this lot over this side. There are 8 this evening. Ladies and gents on this side, have you got your favourites? That man over there and this young lady here. No one else. Have you got your favourites?
Yeah.
Have you got your favourites?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. It's terrible, isn't it? If I had prizes to give away this side of the room, you'd all get one.
Yeah.
Definitely. Well done indeed to all our contestants this evening. I'm going to put a little bit of music on just while we're waiting for our judges to make up their minds, and then we're going to come back very, very soon and get the final 3 acts for you all to vote on this evening. And hopefully, someone will go away with a £100 cash prize. Woo! And someone will win 2nd and 3rd. I don't know what the prizes are, but someone will come 2nd and 3rd. So ladies and gents, hopefully you are all back in your places again once more this evening as we announce our winners this evening. The ones that managed to get through, the ones that have done very, very well indeed. And for this, we are going to be going to our judges once again this evening. So, I have been given a piece of paper up here, and on this piece of paper is a complete list of names, and there is no first place. I haven't been given a first place yet. It's not an envelope. I would love to have an envelope, but unfortunately I haven't. So, ladies and gents, boys and girls up there, if you have entered into Southery Has Got Talent this year, can I ask you please to start making your way to the stage so that we can have all of the contestants, up on the stage at one time. Everyone. So, ladies and gents, I would ask you please if you could put your hands together one more time for all of the contestants this evening. No matter whether they get through or whether they don't, they have all been absolutely wonderful in their own way. They've made everything they've done their own. Is that right? Judges, each one of them have made everything they've done their own. Is that right, yeah? Okay, right, now, I was going to go to the judges and ask them exactly why they put these people through, but they thought it was very harsh and that I shouldn't be putting people on the spot. So, in no particular order, because that's what I've got in front of me, we have got through to the final. We have drum roll. Very, very well done indeed. Right, we also, another drum roll. Must congratulate Sydney. Well done indeed for you. And in true fashion, ladies and gents, we will be announcing who else gets through after this song.
Thank you.
So ladies and gents, we're going to be kicking off again this evening. Please make your way back to your chairs once again this evening so that you can witness all of the acts. The three that have got through need your votes. Our judges, I believe, no longer have a say. So what's it like to have this burden lifted? Is it lovely? Do you know what? I think I'm going to come over and just have a very, very quick chat with our judges just while we're waiting. It's Jess through next door. Kevin. That would be a yes, because I've been seeing her and he's not answering. So, all in all, a good night. Very good night. They made everything their own. The three that got through deserve to get through, each on their own merits. You think so? You believe? Yes is the answer you're looking for. Yes is the answer you're looking for. So Jane, if you could sum up all of the acts that you've seen so far tonight. Wait for it. If you could sum up all of the acts tonight in just three words, what would they be? You can do it too.
Totally amazing.
Thank you very much indeed. That's very, very high praise coming from a woman of your caliber. Oh yes. So she set the bar now. We've got all of the acts just totally amazing. So Claire, can you do it in two words as well? You need to think. Okay, I'll come back to you then. Nicole.
Outstanding.
You got one. Okay, go on then.
Fab, you lost.
Congratulations. Thank you very much indeed to our judges once again this evening for parting out. The fact that you can do it in two words or under. Right, so we are going to be looking for our finalists this evening. And hopefully, through the other side, we are going to have young Jess. Jess, would you like to start making your way up to the stage once again? And for those of you who can't quite remember, Jess is a 9-year-old pupil at Southery Academy. She likes reading, maths, singing, going to youth club, and her favourite group is Dear Mix. Even though she's singing a song by Jess Green, which I love. So, we're hopefully going to have this taken away once again. And the stage is yours.
Wrapped up, so consumed by all this hurt. If you ask me, don't know where to start. Anger, love, confusion, roads to go. No. Broken faith, gave you mine and a hint to hold. Call before I hit the ground. Tell me instead if you got me now. Would you take the wheel if I lose control? If I'm lying here, or would you take me home? Could you take care of a broken soul? Would you hold me now, or would you take me home? 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 You say space will make it better in time, will make it heal. I won't be lost forever, and soon it will feel like I'm haunted. Ooh, oh, oh, falling. You say space will make it better, and time will make it heal. I won't be lost forever, and soon it will feel like I'm haunted. Ooh, oh, oh, falling. Would you take the wheel if I lose control? If I'm lying here, or would you take me home? Could you take care of a broken soul? Would you hold me now, or would you take me home? 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 Or would you take me home?
Thank you very, very much indeed. And while they're being put out of a job, really, I mean, you're retired now, aren't you? You've got nothing left to do. Have you even got tickets for yourselves? You haven't even got tickets for yourselves. So now you can say what you want, can't you? You haven't got to lie anymore. But you're really and truthfully the only people I could ask. So I believe that I asked Claire last time, which means that I'm going to go to Jane. Jane, what would you like to say? How many people would you like to persuade to put their tickets into that box?
All of them.
All of them? But you haven't even heard the others yet. She's absolutely amazing. She's absolutely brilliant. Ladies and gents, Jane recommends that you put all of your tickets into Jess's box. Which means we might as well not have the others up. Do you agree with her? No, you don't agree with her. She's amazing, but everyone's got to make their own decisions. Everyone's got to make their own decisions they have. And ladies and gents, it doesn't cost you to vote this evening. There is no text charge. There's not going to be a charge. Oh, please, you found that. I didn't know where it was. There's not going to be a charge for entering on the internet. So we are looking for our next contestant up this evening to try and win all of your tickets. So, Izzy, would you like to start making your way through from the other side? And hopefully I can get your guitar sounding the way it should do, first time round this time. Do you know I timed that piece of music to perfection? And it's all gone wrong. All the way through the night. Still, you can't win them all. Do you want to give us a note just to check that it's on? Oh, hang on, stop. I've got to press the right button. Try again.
Only falls
Thank you very, very much indeed. You're all good to go. So ladies and gents, she is very, very good at playing guitar. I'm going to come and grab this lead, swing that over there, and I'm going to let Kev Dunn do the rest for me. He's a lovely lad, he really, really is. Don't you think so? Who said, oh, it's this side of the room again, isn't it? This side of the room.
Oh wait, who's Kevin?
It's family. Well, family, it's good that family love him. Someone's got to. So, right. It's another family member. It is indeed. They get everywhere, don't they? So we're going to come to our second judge this evening and see how many people you think should vote. But is it? You can tell I forgot that, couldn't you? It was on my face. So how many people in this lovely room do you think should... Let's have a look around at the faces. How many people should vote and how many people are going to?
I think a lot of people should vote just because the passion and emotion behind her voice and how beautiful her voice is just fabulous. Just wow.
Thank you very much indeed. So lots and lots of people should vote because it's absolutely fabulous and wow. Which means that Claire has to come up with something equally funny at the end. So Claire, you've got like 3 minutes to think about it. To convince people that they need to vote for somebody else. It's got to be a very persuasive argument. So ladies and gents, once again, we are going to be turning the lights down. We have buckets of sand at the front. If you are afraid of the dark, please do not scream. Hold your children by the hand, unless you don't like them, in which case give them to someone else to hold by the hand. If I can ask someone who's near that plug over there to flick that one off. Fire extinguishers? Did we have them the first time round?
Yes.
Did we?
Yes.
I thought you knew something that I didn't this time. Well, giving the fire extinguishers to Kevin.
Oi! I won't be the first time
about
to use it with a Rooney about.
Right. So I'm going to flip behind here, and we are going to get our final contestant up this evening. So, Cindy, would you like to come and take centre stage once again? And are you sure 2 minutes is okay? Okay, all right, 2 minutes. Not gonna be, ladies and gents, please put your hands once again together. Let's hear you go, Barry. Thank you very, very much again. We're gonna flip just a couple of lights on, I think, here, just to see if we can bring that out. God, it smells, doesn't it? What was that, Martin? Right, so ladies and gents, it's down to you now. You are the judges. There's only one more person that needs to say anything to try and sway your mind. So, Claire, you've had lots and lots of time to come up with something. More than the other judges. So this has got to be so much better than she made it her own. Okay, all right, take it away. You, last convincing.
Skill is amazing. The what you do and the speed that you do with the spinning is just there. You are. It was with chains, wasn't it? Yeah. It amazing. The skill, as I said, I'm repeating myself here, and how fast you do it and the repetitive to keep it going is just wonderful. I don't know, I'm repeating myself now.
You won't say
that. What I would like to say though is it's been a wonderful evening. The entertainment throughout the whole evening has been stunning. Southery has got talent.
Wow! That was this side of the room!
And it's nice to see acts coming back each year or every other year, and to see the improvements, what they're doing, which is fantastic. And just a big thank you to Kat for putting the event on as well.
So, thank you very much indeed. This is actually my first time of hosting Southery's Got Talent. And yeah, thanks for that. And I would like to say that whether you're here or whether you've gone, if you've gone, bye. But if you're here, every person that has got up on the stage and done what they've done is so much braver than me. Because I couldn't do it. Not up on a stage, not a cappella, not with chains and balls and fire, not with a horse running around. Sorry, Sven. I couldn't do it. Some of it's very, very hard, and they're very, very small, some of them. 6 years old was the youngest one. What were you doing when you were six? Chris? You weren't doing this, were you?
No.
It takes a lot of guts. So well done indeed to all the competitors. Thank you very much indeed, ladies and gents. And I hope that you can cast your votes very, very wisely. I am unsure as to where the boxes are. They're over there. Are they labelled? So ladies and gents, please head your way over to that side. Put your ticket in the box that you think it should go in. And don't forget to frequent the bar on your way back. But unfortunately, there can only be one prize winner this evening. I say that, but there's actually four piles behind me here. So, ladies and gents, we are going to give three boxes of chocolates to our three lovely ladies in front of you. Congratulations to the judges this evening. Thank you very much for making the hard call when it really mattered. I wouldn't have liked to have been in your chairs this evening, I really wouldn't. Not just because I could stick a microphone in your face at any time, but also because you three had to decide between 10 down to 3. So well done indeed for getting us that far. And ladies and gents out there this evening, the judges will now give you a standing round of applause. Stand up. For your decision this evening. Can we have our final three up on the stage? You haven't got a drum roll, Rich, they know who they are. Right, so we have our three lovely ladies up on the stage, and I have the results in my grubby little paw down here this evening. So, because I know what the result is, and because I want to whip the crowd up just that little bit more, ladies and gents, if you voted for Cindy, can you please give me a cheer? Ladies and gents, if you voted for Jess, can you give me a cheer? They're louder. They're louder. What happened there? And ladies and gents, if you voted for Izzy, can you give yourselves a really big cheer? That's even louder. A bit shorter, but even louder. So well done indeed to all of our finalists this evening. Now, am I going to go first or third? Am I going to go second, first, third? Does anyone care? Okay, right, you can decide. How are we going to do this?
Third place.
Right, so ladies and gents, in third place this evening, drum roll! In third place this evening, Jess! Would you like to say a point? This is for you. Congratulations and well done indeed. Very, very well done. Would you like to say a few words to your adoring fans, the ones that voted for you? No. Would you like to say a few words to those who didn't vote for you?
Come on, Jeff.
One word.
Idiots.
Idiots. Yeah, I'm with that. Yeah, well done indeed. Thank you very much indeed, Jess. You want to stay there? You can stay there. Right, so that means we have two places left, so it would be impolite to now tell you who won. So we're going to have to go with second place this evening. Oh,
check it out, I didn't even have to ask.
Where are you going? I can't remember. Congratulations, second place, Izzy! Well done indeed to you! Congratulations to yourself. Would you like to say a few words to those who did vote for you?
Thank you.
And to those who didn't vote for you?
No comment.
No comment. I'm with idiots. I think idiots was much better. I do. So well done indeed to you, which means, ladies and gents, we don't need a drum roll, because we do know who has now come first. And if you don't, then you really, really are an idiot. So well done indeed to our lovely lady in the middle. Congratulations. Ladies and gents, please put your hands together one more time. Very, very well done indeed for coming. Do you want to say a few words, just in general?
I want to thank my brother for making the poi today. He did do it last minute and he made them from scratch. So thank you very much. And also thanks to the people that voted. Cheers!
Thank you very much, Olivia. You missed the ones who didn't vote for you. The ones who voted for the others.
These guys were awesome.
They were awesome. I think you're all awesome. Well done indeed. So ladies and gents, please give moving up to your finalists this evening. Well done indeed to Cindy from winning Southery's Got Talent. Well done indeed to Izzy for coming second, and well done indeed to Jess for coming third. So, ladies and gents, it appears we need one more setup for Cindy to take centre stage once again and just show us how much talent she has. So ladies and gents, once again, if you have children, keep them back. If we can get Martin and his buckets at the ready. Kevin and his fire extinguishers. Cindy, but I think that we need to congratulate just one more person on yet another fantastic evening. So, Kath, where are you hiding? Would you please just come to me? You said I can improvise. You didn't say that I couldn't improvise about this. No, you didn't. No, there was nothing in this that I... Well, no, I won't give you the... No, I won't make you sing. No, no, no. So thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gents, can you please give Kath a little round of applause? She's very, very good. She is. Do you want to say a word to your helpers?
Thank you to everyone who helped and came and enjoyed the evening.
That will do. Ladies and gents, thank you very much indeed, Kath. But please enjoy the rest of your evening and have a lovely Christmas.